cast iron part that's been welded and heat treated, and my milling machines were busy, so I'm shaping the surface that needs to be machined. But I thought this would be useful to get a look at this, because a setup like this is also useful on an E-mill, a bridge fork, and sometimes even a boring mill, horizontal. That's a surface to be machined. It's mild steel on ductile iron, and even though it's been up to 1600 degrees, it'll give an end mill fits, but it doesn't bother the shaper. The depth gauge says I've got about another 65-67 thousandths to go. Set it on the side here. But you can get a look at this. There's nothing holding this other than that knee and some clamps. This clamp has about 1,200 pounds of force, and the large one here, 2,600. These are not terribly tight. And then I've got 2 4-inch clamps on the front end of the swivel. And you see how it sets inside there. Pulling it back for odd shapes. When you set it up, it's nice to have tapers, my machine tool, wedges. And then here's a brilliant one. You can't have enough of it. But to get a good look, and I'll step back a second, and I'll take probably about a 50 thousandths cut, and maybe 15 or so to finish, to get it to 6 1/2 inches. And again, there's nothing holding it straight down against the table, but that knee and that little bit of clamping is all you need to get the job done. This is not one of those deals where you just beat on a vise and twist things out of shape. And when we come back, it'll be machined.
See, it's running pretty steady. That's near a 16th depth cut, about a 12,000 chip load. I usually will just go off and do something else when this is happening. But there's really no shake, and there's no fussing with the setup. See if I can turn this a little bit to show that I've got rubber bands on my clamps. Anytime you have geared machinery, that's pretty useful. Keeps them from chattering and making you crazy. I'll zoom in a little bit. Struggle at all, even though that's a fairly tough surface and it's got a little cast iron mixed up in it. It'll go in the mid to high 30s for Rockwell.
rubber bands also. And when we come back, we'll show the finish cut. Well, we're back. We were away for a while. I set it to finish. Final cut will be about 16 pounds.